An MSP has been cleared of defamation after a Wildcat business attempted to bring a £750,000 claim against him over social media and blog posts. Scottish Greens MSP Andy Wightman was found by Lord Clark not to have defamed Wildcat Haven Enterprises after labelling it a tax haven in his blog posts. Wildcat Haven Enterprises had been demanding £750,000 plus interest from the politician. The judgment from Lord Clark said, "I conclude that the pursuer has failed to prove any loss." Paul O'Donoghue had claimed blog posts written by the Lothian MSP about his business contained false statements and damaged the firm's reputation. The company sells souvenir plots of land to members of the public, although Mr. Wightman argued buyers did not actually own them as they could not register them with the Land Registry of Scotland. He also raised questions about where the firm was registered. The judge found Mr. Wightman in the various publications founded upon. The defender made 4 untrue statements, but they had not amounted to defamation under Scots law following a hearing at the Court of Session. In the 64-page judgment, Lord Clark wrote, "The defamation claims made by the pursuer fail because the meanings alleged are not made out, or available defences apply. The pursuer's claim for damages, in the sum of £750,000, must fail." On the issue of damage or loss to the company, the judgment states, "In his evidence, Mr. O'Donoghue stated that the impact of the defamatory imputations was still being felt and the relationship between the pursuer and the press, media and local schools had changed completely. As to loss of sales, there was no satisfactory evidence of a downturn in sales, or that it was caused by the blogs or other publications, or to what extent any such downturn had resulted in actual loss to the pursuer. The fact that the defender has made certain statements which are untrue does not itself mean that the defamatory allegations complained of by the pursuer were made." Mr. Wightman, who raised £116,417 in crowdfunding from 3,202 donations to fight the defamation claims, said he was hugely encouraged by their support. On Twitter after the verdict, Mr. Wightman said an expenses hearing will take place, but donors will be pleased to know that I will be able to refund them a substantial part of their donation and will be in touch in due course on this. In a statement following the judgment, Mr. Wightman said, "I'm delighted with this judgment from Lord Clark. I would like to thank my legal team of Campbell Dean and Roddy Dunlop QC for their support, diligence and hard work over the past 3 years. I'd also like to thank my family and colleagues at work for their support and understanding over this period." He added, "I want to pay particular thanks to the thousands of people." WH For more on this story, visit the news article link.